Hi, I'm Ben Benson from the Sanford PROMISE Community Lab at Sanford Research. I'm here to share with you tips on the proper use of a micropipette. This piece of equipment is commonly used in the biomedical science research lab, and we want to make sure you can use it with confidence. By mastering a few simple techniques, you will have an important new lab tool and your accuracy will increase. But before you can get started, there are a couple of important first steps to take. First, before working in a lab, you must be sure to wear your personal protective equipment, PPE. Choose PPE appropriate to the hazards you are working with. Next, look at your lab space. In addition to PPE, it is important to set up your lab space so that all samples and containers are within your arm's reach. Also, clean your space and clear it of unnecessary items. Make sure you have appropriate waste containers for your used tips and arrange your workstation so you don't have to reach over your samples. Being able to recognize the parts of the pipette is important. This is a commonly used pipette brand at Sanford Research. The pipette you use may be a different brand and may look slightly different, but it should have these basic parts. The plunger. Press the plunger to pick up and dispense liquid. The ejector button. Press the eject button to release the used tip. The tip holder is where the disposable pipette tip attaches. The volume adjustment. Turn this knob to set the desired volume. Volume indicator displays the volume of the liquid you will be transferring. Pipettes are used along with plastic disposable pipette tips to measure or transfer small amounts of liquid, usually from 0.2 microliters to 1,000 microliters, or 1 milliliter. The range of volume an individual pipette measures is typically printed on the handle. The volume of the pipette can be adjusted by rotating the volume adjust knob to the desired volume. Remember, the dial numbers indicate different volumes depending upon which pipette is used. You should never use a pipette to measure volumes outside of its intended range. Doing so can cause inaccurate measurements and will damage the internal mechanisms of the pipette. There is a hook on the back side of the pipette. Place the hook over your pointer finger. If properly held, your hand should look like a fist around the pipette, and you should be able to reach and depress the plunger and eject buttons with your thumb. There are two stops on the pipette. A gentle press, like a pen click, brings you to the first stop. Pushing harder or further, like the thumb war, should get you to the second stop. Make sure that when you are filling the pipette, you use only the first stop. This measures the liquid. The second stop allows a small burst of air behind the liquid to ensure that the liquid was expelled from the tip. To keep your micropipette from being contaminated by liquids and to measure appropriate volumes, you will need a disposable pipette tip. Tips are inexpensive and differ in size and brand to fit your micropipette. Once you set your pipette to the volume needed, attach the appropriate pipette tip to the end of the pipette. To do this, hold the pipette with one hand, aim into the opening in the tip, and gently but firmly push the pipette into the pipette tip. Tips should be arranged in a tip box. You should not have to slam the tip into the end of the pipette. The tip only needs to be on far enough so that it doesn't fall off. To use the pipette, depress the plunger to the first stop. Keep the plunger at this level. Submerge the tip just past the level of the liquid you want to draw up. Slowly release the plunger, allowing it to return to its original position. Pause for a second to make sure all of the required volume has been taken into the tip. This is especially important when pipetting more viscous or thicker materials. Withdraw the pipette tip from the liquid, position the tip inside the recipient container, and slowly depress the plunger. This will release the liquid. This time, push beyond the first stop to the second stop. This ensures any residual liquid is expelled from the pipette tip. Fully withdraw the pipette tip from the liquid before you release the plunger. Use a new pipette tip with each new liquid. If the tip touches any surface or any liquid other than the one you are pipetting, discard it and get a new one. Once you are finished pipetting, dispose of your tip by aiming the base of the pipette over the waste container and depressing the eject button. This should eject the tip from the pipette into the container. If you think your tip may be contaminated, remember the PROMISE Lab's easy rule for tips. When in doubt, throw it out. Let's review what we've learned. To use a pipette, depress the push button until you feel some resistance. This is the first stop. Place the pipette into the liquid and slowly release the button. To release the liquid from the pipette, push past the first stop to fully expel the liquid from the pipette tip into the recipient container. Before you release the push button, withdraw the pipette from the container. Once you have aspirated the liquid, press down on the tip ejector to release the pipette tip from the pipette. The tip ejector is a small button at the bottom of the main body of the pipette. Make sure the attached pipette tip is inside the appropriate waste container before pressing the eject button. Now let's take a look at a few things not to do, or bloopers. First, do not press down before putting the tip into the liquid. This helps to avoid bubbles. When putting the tip on the pipette, do not slam your tip onto the table. This ruins the bottom of the tip, plus it introduces unwanted contamination. Do not use a pipette that does not have a tip attached. Liquids should never enter the body of the pipette. It will cause pipette corrosion and be a major source of contamination. Do not use a pipette past the volume limits listed on the handle. Not only does this cause inaccuracies, but also damages the pipette. Sometimes you may struggle to attach a tip to a pipette. If so, do not repeatedly jam the pipette into the tip. This can damage the pipette, and if your tip doesn't stay on the end of the pipette, simply repeat the proper procedure with a new tip. When taking up liquids, do not simply let go of the push button. The liquid may be sprayed around the inside walls of the tip and up into the pipette body. This can cause inaccurate volume dispensing and pipette contamination. Release the push button in a controlled way. Do not slam the plunger down to move the liquid to a new container. This will spray out too strong. When you are using a filter, check the tip fit and the rules. By following these do's and steering clear of the bloopers, you will stay safe and keep your equipment in top shape and see your lab accuracy grow.